In geometry, we learned how to find the area of many shapes, including rectangles, circles, triangles, and trapezoids. Each of these shapes has defined formulas to help us determine their areas, usually based on parameters like their height, length, or radius. But what if we wanted to determine the area lying beneath a curve? In this video, we are going to talk about a method called Riemann sums for approximating areas like these. Let's take a look at that curve again. We haven't yet gone over a well-defined method of determining the exact area beneath it, but we can start to get an idea of what the true area is close to by drawing in rectangles on the graph like this. Here we have drawn rectangles of equal width. In this case, their widths are 1 unit wide, where each rectangle is as tall as the height of the curve on the rectangle's left corner. When you do this, some of your rectangles will be taller than your curve and some will be shorter than your curve. By finding the areas of each of these rectangles and adding them all together, we can get an approximation, or an estimate of the area beneath the curve. Let's find each of the rectangle's areas now. Remember, the area of a rectangle equals its width times its length. In this example, each rectangle has a width of 1. The first rectangle is 2 units tall, so its area is 1 times 2, which equals 2. The next rectangle is 1 unit tall, so its area is 1 times 1, which equals 1. The third rectangle is 2 units tall, so it has an area of 1 times 2, which equals 2. The fourth rectangle is 4 units tall, with an area equal to 4. And the fifth rectangle is 5 units tall, so its area is equal to 5. Adding all of these together, we have a total area of 14 square units. Just like that, we have made an approximation for the area beneath the curve. The process we just followed is called the left Riemann sum. Left because we drew each rectangle to the height of the curve on its left side. Similarly, the rectangles for a right Riemann sum would look like this, with each rectangle drawn up to the height of the curve on its right side. These rectangles have heights of 1, 2, 4, 5, and 5 respectively. And since each of these rectangles again has a width of 1, those areas add up to 17 square units. Clearly, this is different from the solution we just came up with using the left Riemann sum. This is because, once again, Riemann sums are just approximations of the true area. Notice how much area the left rectangles missed and how much area the right rectangles added on. This naturally leads to the question, how can we improve these approximations and minimize error? We could do this by decreasing the width of each rectangle and adding more rectangles in. Let's take a look at the same curve's left rectangles when we decrease their width from 1 unit to 1/2 unit. Of course, there are still some error gaps present, where either too much or too little area is accounted for. But if we compare this to the previous estimation, we can see that this shaded area has been eliminated and that these shaded areas have been added in. So we see that because we increase the number of rectangles, we now have a better approximation of the true value beneath the curve. Let's try a formal example now. Consider the function f of x equals negative x cubed plus 25x. Approximate the area beneath the curve from x equals 0 to x equals 5 by finding the left and right Riemann sums, each with 5 rectangles of width 1. Then find the left and right Riemann sums with 10 rectangles of width 1/2. Compare each approximation to the true area value, 156.25 square units. There's obviously a lot here, so we're going to take this one bit at a time. The function we are working with is f of x equals negative x cubed plus 25x, and we are looking at the portion of the curve from x equals 0 to x equals 5. Our first task is finding the left Riemann sum with 5 rectangles of width 1. This means that the left corners of each rectangle will lie on x equals 0, x equals 1, x equals 2, x equals 3, and x equals 4 respectively. Even though we don't have a picture of the graph in front of us for this problem, we can calculate the heights of those rectangles by plugging those x values into the function. The first rectangle, whose left corner lies on x equals 0, will have a height of f of 0, which is equal to negative 0 cubed plus 25 times 0, or 0. The second rectangle's left corner lies on x equals 1, so its height will be f of 1, which is equal to negative 1 cubed plus 25 times 1, or negative 1 plus 25, which equals 24. The third rectangle's left corner lies on x equals 2, so its height is f of 2, which equals negative 2 cubed plus 25 times 2, or negative 8 plus 50, which equals 42. The fourth rectangle's left corner is at x equals 3, so its height is f of 3, which equals negative 3 cubed plus 25 times 3, or negative 27 plus 75, which equals 48. The fifth and final rectangle has its left corner at x equals 4, so its height will be f of 4, which is equal to negative 4 cubed plus 25 times 4, which equals negative 64 plus 100, or 36. Each of these rectangles has a width of 1, so their areas, width times height, are each just going to be equal to their height. These areas are again 0, 24, 42, 48, and 36, which all add up to 150 square units. Let's now compute the right Riemann sum. For each of the five rectangles, we will need to compute the heights at their right corners. The first rectangle's right corner lies on x equals 1. We've already calculated the height at x equals 1 to be 24, so the first rectangle for the right Riemann sum is then 24 units tall. The second rectangle's right corner lies on x equals 2, and again, we already know the height there. Since f of 2 is equal to 42, the second rectangle is 42 units tall. The third rectangle ends at x equals 3 and will have a height of 48. The fourth rectangle ends at x equals 4 and will have a height of 36. The fifth and final rectangle ends at x equals 5. We will need to plug this into the function to find the height. F of 5 is equal to negative 5 cubed plus 25 times 5, which is equal to negative 125 plus 125, which equals 0. So the last rectangle has a height of 0. Again, the widths of these rectangles are all 1, so in this case, their areas are simply equal to their heights. Adding all of these together, we see that the right Riemann sum with 5 rectangles is 24 plus 42 plus 48 plus 36 plus 0, or 150 square units. Coincidentally, this is the same as the left Riemann sum we got moments ago. For this example, they happen to be the same value. However, this is not always and often isn't the case with left and right Riemann sums. Remember in the problem statement, we were asked to find the Riemann sums using 5 and then 10 rectangles. Let's proceed and find the left Riemann sum with 10 rectangles now. Since we are observing the same domain from x equals 0 to x equals 5, increasing the number of rectangles means that we must decrease their width. Now each rectangle will have a width of 1/2. Let's go ahead and compute the height of the function at intervals of 1/2 now, so we can calculate the areas and sum more quickly in the next steps. Now the left rectangles will have left corners at each of these points from 0 to 4.5, so we will be considering each of those heights. In the previous Riemann sums, each rectangle had a width of 1, which made calculating the areas very simple. Now, since our rectangles have a width of 1/2, each rectangle's area will be equal to 1/2 times its height. So the first rectangle will have an area of 0.5 times 0, which equals 0. The second will have a height of 0.5 times 12.375, which equals 6.1875, and so on. Here are all of the left rectangle's areas now. Adding these all together, we get that the left Riemann sum with 10 rectangles is 154.6875 square units. Now, we are also interested in the right Riemann sum with 10 rectangles. From the heights we found, we can again find each of these areas by multiplying the heights by 1/2. Here are the areas of each right rectangle, whose right corners are at 1/2 intervals from x equals 0.5 to x equals 5. These areas all add up to 154.6875 square units. Even though this value is again the same as what we got for the left Riemann sum, this will not always be the case. This function arcs in such a way that the left and right sums happen to come out equal. The last part of the problem is for us to compare each approximation to the true area. Using 5 rectangles, we approximated the area to be 150 square units. With 10 rectangles, the approximation was refined to 154.6875 square units. The true area is equal to 156.25 square units. We can clearly see that increasing the number of rectangles in the Riemann sum helped to make the approximation more precise. When it comes to Riemann sums, it's important to remember that when calculating the areas of each rectangle, you must multiply its height by its width, which will sometimes be one unit and other times not. Also, keep in mind that these are approximations of the true area beneath the curve. There will still be some margin of error, but this error can be minimized by using more rectangles. I hope that this video is helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying.